They died, were buried, and nearly forgotten until now. Tonight, that piece of local slave history is being preserved forever. Margo Johnson is live in Surry County with the story. Margo?
Well, Wanda, you're right. It was some Boy Scouts, and today, local historians who showed them where to look showed us what they found.
Wooded area on the banks of the Fisher River in Mount Airy. Not far from the corn and tobacco fields they planted and harvested.
This is probably a headstone.
Marion Venable shows us the slave cemetery confirmed by a local Boy Scout working on a project.
Well, right there's one.
The slaves lived and worked on a plantation owned by the Edwards and Franklin families, state and congressional politicians more than 200 years ago.
100 or more people could have potentially been buried here.
Not much is known about the slaves, but their owners did keep good records.
You're remembering Bob and Jacob, and we're remembering Melissa and Isabel and Charles. And we remember Sarah, Delcy.
Emma Jean Tucker can barely hold back her emotions as she reads the names of the people believed to be buried here.
Somebody's mom, somebody's sister, somebody's
baby.
Almost a tearjerker because Tucker is a descendant of slaves who came from a plantation not far from here.
We don't want them to be forgotten.
And now they won't. This memorial will serve as a reminder to everyone who comes here to learn about the history of this area.
Here is one.
The only documented slave cemetery in Surry County.
But we are making a point that these people were not anonymous.
And at 6:30 this evening, that cemetery will be dedicated here in Mount Airy. It is on Haystack Road off of Highway 89. It is about 7 miles west of the city. Back to you.
All right, thanks a lot, Margo.